Number 7, defender Ellie Reed. Number 8, midfielder Kim Little. Number 9, forward Merritt Mathias. Number 10, midfielder Jessica Fishlock. Number 13, defender Kendall Fletcher. Number 17, forward Beverly Yanez. And number 19, midfielder Hannah Salon. The Seattle Reign is coached by Laura Harvey. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to introduce today's starting lineup for your FC Kansas City. Team captain, number 4, defender Becky Sauerbrunn. In goal, team co-captain, number 18, Nicole Bonnert. Number 2, forward Shay Groom. Number 3, midfielder Desiree Scott. Number 5, defender Alex Arlett. Number 7, forward Mandy Laddish. Number 9, midfielder Heather O'Reilly. Number 10, defender Yael Averbush. Number 13, defender Brittany Taylor. Number 15, midfielder Erica Timrak. And number 21, defender Katie Bowen. Head coach for FC Kansas City is Vlatko Andonovsky. Ladies and gentlemen, FC Kansas City. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask you please rise and direct your attention to the giant American flag at the center of the field and join us all in paying respect to the Stars and Stripes as Dontarius Young sings our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
Building.
Fans, please direct your attention to the pitch for today's coin toss. Referee Greg Dopka, assistant referees Ben Pilgrim and Ryan Cook, with fourth official Devin Blazek, are joined by Reign team captain Keelan Winters and FC Kansas City captain Becky Sauerbrunn. Blues fans, back in March, three players training with the Washington Spirit were affected by a house fire at the home of their host family. Spearheaded by our own Yael Averbush, an online auction was set up through Kansas City-based EquipBids. Through the auction, from items donated by our players and coaches, with matching funds from FC Kansas City ownership, we were able to raise $5,000 to help these girls who lost all their belongings in the fire. Here to present Tiffany Weimer, one of the three players affected by that fire, who currently trains with the Blues, with a check for those funds, is FC Kansas City owner Chris Likens. Thank you, Chris Likens, the Likens family, and those fans who purchase items through this special auction.
And welcome into Swope, a soccer village in Kansas City, Missouri, for tonight's presentation of the National Women's Soccer League. The home side, FC Kansas City, the two-time league defending champions, playing host to Seattle Reign FC, arguably the two most successful franchises in the short three-and-a-half-year history of the National Women's Soccer League. Seattle Reign FC has won the league shield the last couple of years, while FC Kansas City has won the league championship the last 2 years, and arguably the two best coaches in the National Women's Soccer League. The starting lineups for each side will look familiar. We'll go through Seattle first. They will start Lauren Barnes, Rachel Corsi, Ellie Reed, Kim Little, Merritt Mathias, the former FC Kansas City player, Jessica Fishlock. Keelan Winters will serve as the captain, Kendall Fletcher, Beverly Yanez, and Havana Salon. For FC Kansas City, it will be Shea Groom up top, Desiree Scott, one of those holding midfielders, Becky Sauerbrunn, the best defender in the world, central midfielder, Alex Arless, Mandy Laddish, Heather O'Reilly, Yael Averbush, Brittany Taylor, Erica Timrak, Nicole Barnhart, and Katie Brown. Both sides playing better of late after rough starts to the 2016 season for the Seattle Reign FC, coached by Laura Harvey, the back-to-back NWSL Coach of the Year, back-to-back Shield winners for her squad. They are 3-3-2 with 12 points from their 9 games. They are 2 spots ahead of FC Kansas City in the standings with Sky Blue FC in between. They're coming off a scoreless draw with Sky Blue FC. And points in the last 3 games, a scoreless draw with Portland, a 1-0 win over Houston, and another scoreless draw with Sky Blue FC. And that all followed a 1-1 draw and a friendly with the Arsenal Ladies FC, which Laura Harvey knows very well. For FC Kansas City, they are coached by Vlatko Andonovski in his 4th season as head coach, the back-to-back NWSL champions. They are 2-4-3 with 9 points from 9 games, 3rd from the bottom in the NWSL. 7 points from the last 3 games, a 2-0 win over Orlando, a 1-1 draw with Sky Blue FC, and a 1-0 win over Houston. And now Seattle, the first to marginally break through the opposition defense. But Heather O'Reilly will turn it the other way. Erica Timrak, pardon me, for FC Kansas City. O'Reilly making a run down the right side. and you'll see her working the flank all night long. But again, back to FC Kansas City. Before taking points in the last three games, in the first six games, they had 0 wins, 2 draws. So a rough start for the defending champs, rough start for both teams, and we'll see how they bounce back against each other. I talked to people from both sides before the game, and this is a big game in terms of setting yourself back into the playoff race as we approach the midpoint of the season. Of course, there will be a long break for the Olympics, which the U.S. women's team will be the favorites going in, as they are the defending World Cup champions. And several players from these two sides will be with the U.S. women's national team. In fact, the roster for the latest tune-up came out this week, and now here's Seattle headed back, and now a chance in front for Reign FC. A shot fired and parried away by Nicole Barnhart. What a shot in front by Seattle Reign FC, and they'll get a corner out of this. Nice build-up by Seattle, and here's another look at it. The shot gets touched just outside that far post for Seattle. Now taking the corner for Seattle Reign, Lauren Barnes, the 27-year-old UCLA product, making her 10th start and 10th appearance of the season. And that's a shot, goes just to the far post, tip in front, dangerously Seattle with a chance, but Desiree Scott clears it for FC Kansas City, at least momentarily. Collecting it for Seattle is is Merritt Mathias, the former Blues draft pick. And there's Becky Sauber, number 4 for FC Kansas City. She'll be with the national team for the Olympics. The best central defender in the world. If you want to make a case against it, you can try. Lauren Barnes again to take this for Seattle. Played around the world. And the left-footed in-swinger tipped up and towards the far side. Ava Bush will chase it down for the Blues and try to usher it up that near sideline. She's being harassed by Rachel Corsi. And this will be a throw-in for the Blues. Number 13, Brittany Taylor. And that's a number we'd normally associate with Leanne Robinson, or as she's known now, Leanne Brown, who retired this past offseason, one of several retirements for the two-time defending champions. Garcia, and that'll be a foul on Heather O'Reilly, and she took a shot, it looks like, to the throat as her and Merritt Mathias get hooked up, and our match official, Greg Dopka, comes over and sees nothing of it. I talked to Greg Dopka before the game, and they were taking field temperatures, and it's believed that we will have hydration breaks twice during this game. One at the 30-minute mark, depending on when they have a dead ball. It'll be somewhere around the 30-minute mark. And then we could have another at the 75th-minute mark, again, depending on the temperature. The temperatures here in Kansas City, in the Midwest, into the lower 90s, 93 at game time. And our friends from Seattle in the Pacific Northwest, I checked their weather today, and it looked like mid-60s all the way up to 70, so definitely much cooler there. Hope you're enjoying that, but here in the Midwest, it has been a boilerplate for the last 3 weeks or so. And it is definitely hot. The one saving grace is the surface is natural grass. Now Seattle, which has had the advantage in terms of attack here in the opening minutes of the game. So we cross into minute 7. This will be a throw-in on the far side, taken by Ellie Reed, making her 9th start of the campaign. Been with Seattle since 2013, played internationally in Sweden and Australia, as have many of these Seattle Reign FC players. And that'll be touched out of bounds by Jessica Fishlock. And, it's off an FC Kansas City player. So another corner, already the 3rd corner in the opening 7 minutes for Seattle Reign FC. And this will be taken by Kim Little, one of the most effective scorers. And now she'll give way to Lauren Barnes. So this will be another left-footed in-swinger from the far side of the pitch. You can see that flag blowing in the wind, and it is blowing across from the near side to the far side. And this will be sent in right in the middle, bodies up in the air, and it's sent away. Only question is whether this would be a corner or a goal, and this would be another corner for Seattle. So four corners in the opening 8 minutes for Seattle Reign FC. And this one will be taken by Kim Little. Tons of international experience as well as a solid NWSL player. And this will be sent right-footed outswinger, far post, and that's headed away by FC Kansas City. And see if the Averbush can launch the counterattack. Heather O'Reilly is running 100 miles an hour, and she's pointing over to the left side and trying to connect. There is O'Reilly, but it's nicely cut off by Merritt Mathias, the former Blues player. And we'll keep an eye on the other game going on in the National Women's Soccer League. Washington Spirit and Sky Blue FC. Of course, this league weekend got underway Friday night. Western New York absolutely blistering the Boston Breakers 7-1, tied for the most goals scored by a team in league history. And Boston continues to languish as one of the bottom feeders in the league. They have been unable to find a system or a lineup that works. And so they were hammered 7-1 by Western New York on Friday night. And for Western New York fans, that's good news because they get up to 18 points in a tie for second place in the league table. And Blues in Seattle, and again, Seattle gets that advantage, and they have been dominating, cleared away by Salbrun, but this will be a throw-in for Seattle on the far side, and this will be taken by Ellie Reed. Sends it to Kim Little. And Kim Little, what a fantastic career she has had for Seattle, the Mentlaw Scotland native, making her 10th start of the season. Of course, has played in the past with Hibernian, the Arsenal Ladies, joining Seattle in 2014. And what a 2015 season. 20 starts, 10 goals, was third in the league, and her 7 assists, number 1 in the National Women's Soccer League. And now Heather O'Reilly will try to get it up to Shea Groom, and now trying to put something together is FC Kansas City, trying to get it across to Erica Timrak, and bodies crash in the middle, and down hard is Jessica Fishlock, and she's calling for a foul, and she'll get it. And she has a solid case. Shea Groom, the Liberty, Missouri native who played collegiately at Texas A&M. These two sides feature some of the most experienced players, not only in the National Women's Soccer League, but in the entire world. And you'll see many of these players in the Olympics, including Desiree Scott, who's on the ball right now. She'll play for Canada at the Olympics in Rio. And now Heather O'Reilly in a foot race. And her man goes down in the box, and this will be a foul on O'Reilly. Is down in a heap went Rachel Corsi, the 26-year-old from Aberdeen, Scotland. Here's another look at it as O'Reilly was trying to race from the box. Desiree Scott feeding it forward, and there's O'Reilly, and they just kind of clashed together, maybe got her on the back shoulder. So foul on Shea Groom, pardon me, not Heather O'Reilly. At the Rio Olympics coming up this summer, the Americans certainly the favorites after winning World Cup 2015 in Canada. Now FC Kansas City has it. Becky Salbrun cycles it back to Ava Bush. And now to Brittany Taylor on the near right side, who's been a nice addition to FC Kansas City. Spent the 3 seasons with the Western New York Flash, including 2013 when she was in NWSL Best 11 selection. And a nice pickup here, the 28-year-old out of UConn. And now here's Brittany Taylor trying to slide it forward. There's Mandy Laddish making a run. It'll be tipped away, and this will be the first corner for FC Kansas City. Here on the near side, and no doubt that'll be Heather O'Reilly making it over. There's Mandy Laddish, one of the local kids on the team from Lee Summit, Missouri. Notre Dame product, won a national championship her freshman year. And be aware of the short corner as Erica Timrak is standing by. will take the right-footed outswinger, and that'll go right down the middle and headed away by Seattle on a collision of bodies in front, a pile in front, and home fans are calling for a penalty. Desiree Scott is shouting at the officials, wanting a foul call as she was taken down inside the six. And she might have a legitimate argument. Fans are still screaming for a call, and so are the players for the Blues. This will be a throw-in for Seattle on the near side. And let's take another... We're going to replay there, but we'll wait. There's been a slight delay, and our match official is waving the players over to have a little discussion. He's calling over Merritt Mathias. Shea Groom is also being asked to join in the conversation. Keelan Winters, the captain, is right there with our match official. And we will have an extended discussion about this play between Shea Groom and Merritt Mathias, neither showing signs of guilt, both pleading ignorance. Jessica Fishlock also weighing in, never afraid of her opinion. Shea Groom will continue to follow the match official. And this is getting salty here. 14th minute, and the two sides, which have a storied history between each other, as FC Kansas City has beaten Seattle Reign FC in the last two NWSL championships. And so things should be a little salty between the two. Nothing less would be expected. And Mandy Laddish dancing on the ball in the center circle. Cycle it back to Salbrun. Avery Bush. Desiree Scott. There's Taylor. Heather O'Reilly calling for it and getting it. Now O'Reilly will try to catapult this forward. Looking for Erica Timrak. Tries to bring it down on the right foot. Timrak looking for a shooting angle. Timrak, top of the 18, shoots it and blazed it high over the top. Probably 6 yards over the crossbar. Goal kick for Seattle Reign FC, but a nice buildup for FC Kansas City after Seattle had dominated early on. Another look by Tim Rack, and all you see is the cars in the parking lot there as that ball went so high over the crossbar. Dangerously sent out by Hope Solo, goalkeeper for Seattle, and she has a chance to make history here in a couple of weeks. I'll tell you about that in a second as Seattle Reign FC again builds up the attack before it's cut out by Desiree Scott. Nicely done by the Canadian international. She gets set for an Olympic run in Rio here in a few weeks. But Hope Solo, the goalkeeper for Seattle Reign FC, called into the national team camp ahead of their July 9th meeting with South Africa. First time the U.S. and South Africa will face each other in international competition. But for Hope Solo, she is sitting on 99 international shutouts. One more and she reaches 100. Not only is that an American record, that is an international record. So Hope Solo a chance at 100 career shutouts, either July 9th against South Africa, which is a tune-up for the Olympics, or July 22nd, the final tune-up match for the United States as they host Costa Rica. And here's a takedown. Bodies crashing, Avery Bush, and getting mixed up a little bit with Becky Yanez. Another world-class player for Seattle. That July 22nd match, the U.S. and Costa Rica will be here in Kansas City, not on this field, though. It'll be over at Children's Mercy Park in Kansas City, Kansas, which is the home of Sporting Kansas City of Major League Soccer. But they host all of the big international matches. So, again, a lot of these players will be part of the U.S. squad as well as other international squads. Megan Rapinoe, who's unavailable for Seattle tonight as she continues her recovery from ACL surgery, was called into the U.S. camp simply to train, work out, and be under the observation of the U.S. national team medical staff and coaching staff. So they're hoping she can be ready to go for Rio. Hope Solo also called into the national team, as we mentioned. And for FC Kansas City, Becky Salbrun, no doubt co-captain of the national team. And also Heather O'Reilly. I know he was disappointed last summer at not getting called into the team, but she will be part of the squad for the game on July 9th. And they could certainly use her speed on the wings, always. Now Seattle watches it in front, and that's headed away by Averbusch, who's one of the taller players in Major League Soccer, standing 5'10", the North Carolina product, making her 10th start of the campaign. This will be a goal kick for Nicole Barnhart. And Nicole Barnhart having a great stretch over the last six games for FC Kansas City. Former U.S. national team member, back up to Hope Solo for many years. And now look out, a chance for Shea Groom of FC Kansas City. And she's saying she was impeded, and she was. And this will be a free kick for the Blues here on the near half of the pitch. And we'll take another look here at Shea Groom's grievance. And she, and I think an arm got up into the face. And Rachel Corsi may be the guilty party there. And this will be Averbusch.
A yellow card caution has been issued to Seattle defender number 4, Corsi.
And Corsi, for that infraction, has received a yellow card here in the 18th minute. So yellow card 18 for Corsi. First booking of the match. And that's sent in front dangerously and headed towards the net by Shea Groom. And not to be for FC Kansas City. And another look at Averbusch, one of the great free kickers in the league, and look at that. And tell you what, we talked about the retired players for the Blues, players who stepped away from the professional game after winning back-to-back championships, and Lauren Holiday, no doubt, formerly Lauren Cheney, one of the great free kickers all time in U.S. soccer history, as well as the National Women's Soccer League. Heather O'Reilly on the ball, Mandy Laddish trying to link up, and now Taylor along the near side tried to send it back, and that is turned over as unable to handle it was Katie Bowen. The retirements for the Blues: Liz Bogus, Casey Clark, Lauren Holiday, Leanne Brown, formerly Leanne Robinson, Amy LaPelbit, great U.S. national team player, Megan Lisenby, and Jen Buzkowski. And Jen Buzkowski, affectionately known by her friends and teammates and fans as Buzz, one of the great defensive midfield players in women's soccer history. Just a fantastic player. She has gone on, and she has gone back to school, taking care of her studies. Back to Averbusch, and this will go back to Nicole Barnhart. In goal for FC Kansas City. And for Nicole Barnhart, well, she just starts every single game. 10th start of the season, all 10 for FC Kansas City. A .78 goals against average, and she's tied for second in the league with 35 saves. Also has 3 clean sheets on the season. Fishlock and Desiree Scott, that's a battle that could rage all night for the remaining minutes of this game. Two of the most hardcore players in this league. Jessica Fishlock with just so much international experience. Seattle since 2013, but she's played in Scotland, Germany, Australia, the Netherlands, also part of the Wales national team. And perhaps Jessica Fishlock took notice this afternoon in the Euros for the men earlier this afternoon. Wales winning an elimination game for the first time ever, as they won 1-0 over Northern Ireland. And Hugh Williams, assistant coach for FC Kansas City, who hails from Wales, not trying to be a poet, he said, as many times as you want to mention the Wales victory over Northern Ireland during the broadcast, that would be great. So there you go, Hugh. Wales 1-0 over Northern Ireland. They advanced to the knockout round. So congratulations to Hugh Williams, Jessica Fishlock, and all the fans of the Welsh national team. It was an own goal by Northern Ireland, but totally set up. There wasn't much they could do about it. So if you're looking for soccer action on television and online, you can't beat right now anywhere in the world with the National Women's Soccer League, Major League Soccer, Copa America for the men here in the U.S., and the Euros for the men overseas. Just unlimited games from the time you wake up until the time you go to bed, or maybe even drift off to a late game on the West Coast somewhere. That goal for Wales was for the men, and the Euros was set up by Gareth Bale. Highest transfer fee in the history of professional soccer. Sent a cross in, and the defender for Northern Ireland just tried to turn it away and turn it back into his own net. 1-0's the story. Wales wins. And one of those upstart teams in the Euros. Iceland also making a great run in the Euros. Now Heather O'Reilly, and the flag is up and offside on FC Kansas City. Of course, Copa America, the U.S. men playing tonight against Colombia in the third place game. Not sure how much motivation there is for that. And here's another look, and clearly offside, Shea Groom out there in front. The kid from Liberty, Missouri, and her high school coach, Liberty, used to make her do push-ups on the sideline for offside calls. I did a couple of her games, and they were blistering some opponent one night, and she had a couple of goals, and I asked her after the game, I said, why are you doing push-ups on the sidelines? You're clearly winning this game. You're performing well. She goes, well, every time I get caught offside, my coach makes me do push-ups. So perhaps after the game or at halftime, she'll be doing some retroactive push-ups for that offside violation. And now we've entered into a little bit of a lull here in the game. Seattle Reign FC had enjoyed the majority of the possession and the attack in the opening 10 minutes. SC Kansas City had one or two chances, maybe half chances, but now it's been a battle between the middle third. This gets sent along the far sideline for FC Kansas City, and there's Desiree Scott coming into possession. She'll send it out to Timrak, who dummies the play, and it goes outside, and streaming in was Timrak, and nicely dispossessed by Fishlock. Need somebody to just jam the wheels. Jessica Fishlock is your woman. And now this is a throw-in on the far side, and it will be taken by Alex Arlette, making her sixth start and eighth appearance of the season for FC Kansas City. The LSU product out of Houston, Texas, just 22 years old, fourth-round pick, 38th overall this year, and she's getting significant minutes for the two-time defending champs. And Shea Groom tried to, or rather Heather O'Reilly tried to put a stick in front of that and block it. And now Seattle trying to get something down front. And now a chance for Seattle trying to get on the left foot and doing it, but maybe just halfway through as Becky Inez. You talk about international experience, Finland, Japan, here in the U.S., and what a great season last year for Seattle with 9 goals and 1 assist in her 17 starts. That's why I said both these teams have so much star power and experience in the women's professional game. Two of the most successful franchises. Merritt Mathias from Seattle, by the way, just came to the near side to get a drink. And I mentioned earlier, but I'll repeat it again in case you missed it. The match official, Greg Dopko, was taking the field temperature along with officials from the National Women's Soccer League before the game, and we may have a hydration break here at the 30-minute mark or somewhere around there, depending on when there's a break in play. So in about 4.5 minutes, we'll see if that comes to fruition. As we said, the temperatures here in the Midwest and Kansas City today at game time, 93 degrees, and the humidity is through the roof. And soccer has taken better care the last couple of years at the international and league levels of trying to get players hydration breaks when the conditions merit. And FC Kansas City right now having a trouble getting it out of their own end. And that's up to Taylor on the near side. Seattle thought it was out of play, and now it is. And this will be a throw-in for Seattle on the near side. And making her way over is Lauren Barnes. And Barnes looking for an option. Sends it in to Merritt Mathias, tipped away by Desiree Scott. Now in front, Keelan Winters. Fishlock, and she'll go out wide right, trying to find Yanez. Now in front, chipped up and over the top, trying to pick out Kim Little, and just unable to link up. It's Nicole Barnhart stopped the threat, but Kim Little What a fantastic career she has had in the National Women's Soccer League. And now, launching the counter are the Blues. Quickly on it was Katie Bowen, Erica Timrak. Now sending it forward, trying to pick out Heather O'Reilly. And there's O'Reilly with a chance, looking for a right-footed shot. Still O'Reilly. Still O'Reilly. Chipped up far post, and just missed the corner. Heather O'Reilly, a golden opportunity on the counter for FC Kansas City, and just missed by the longtime U.S. international. Another look at this fantastic buildup, and O'Reilly absolutely magic with her feet. Pulls it all the way down, almost to the end line, about 4 feet shy, and just misses the post. O'Reilly called into the U.S. national team for that July 9th game against South Africa. Olympic gold medalist, World Cup veteran. There is the hydration break I mentioned. So here in minute 28 with a dead ball, each team will get 3 minutes for this hydration break. And no doubt that each coach, being veterans as they are, Laura Harvey for Seattle Reign FC and Vlatko Antonovski for FC Kansas City, will use this time to strategize. And there's Vlatko, U.S. citizen here, too many months ago. Fantastic playing career in Europe before coming to the United States. Also coaches the indoor soccer team in Kansas City, the Comets, which has had a lot of success over the years. So it's a hydration break / strategy session. You can see the players getting wet towels to put over their heads and necks. Again, blistering temperatures. The fans now have kind of started streaming out of the stands to hydrate themselves as well. A lot of ice cream, and I saw a lot of yogurt being passed around, a lot of yogurt on ice. And there's Laura Harvey's huddle for Seattle. This is a big game for each side. You look at the standings of the National Women's Soccer League, Seattle Reign FC on 12 points, just outside of that playoff zone. And I was talking to a coach with FC Kansas City before the game, and he said, if we can get this and get the full 3 points, then we get within 3 points of getting into the playoff zone. So for both sides, longtime rivals here in the National Women's Soccer League, this game is big. And they only say June on the calendar, but in terms of importance and what it can do, it's big. As we mentioned in the build-up to the game, each side started their season very slowly and very disappointingly for two teams who have championship pedigree and veteran players. And each team did themselves no favors by burying themselves, but each side over the last 3 games has been getting steady points, climbing up the standings, and getting themselves in position as we now cross the half-hour mark. Still scoreless here in Kansas City. Each team is back on the field. Hope Solo restarts it for Seattle. Looking up ahead to Kim Little. Heather O'Reilly misplays it. And now a chance for Seattle. Yanez on the near side, trying to send it forward. Trying to pick out Little, but a little bit too strong, overheated. Now Averbusch will cycle it back to Barnhart as FC Kansas City assesses how they want to launch their attack as we head into the final 15 minutes of our first half. Seattle doing a very good job of keeping the FC Kansas City attack under wraps, not allowing many creases, especially in the midfield. And now a near collision between Katie Bowen and Keelan Winters. And now here's Seattle once again. Shot left foot, far post, and that's a little bit too strong for Seattle as Havana Salon was a little ambitious with that effort. And there's Salon with the left foot. And Becky Sovereign did well to just stick a peg in the road and make sure that Salon did not have a clean angle to shoot. Now Desiree Scott has it for the Blues, and she pegs Heather O'Reilly right in the back. And now Keelan Winters on for Seattle Reign FC. Lauren Barnes along the near side. Yanez Winters. Look at Seattle. They're just so crisp the way they pass the ball around. Just not in that final finish yet in this match. Now Erica Timrak with speed to burn down the far side. There's Ava Bush. Laddish taps it back dangerously. And back to Barnhart. Boy, FC Kansas City right now just cannot unlock that puzzle to build up a full attack. Becky Sauber now all the way out from her defensive spot. She's in midfield now, and she's still trucking. Now Alex Arlette. And again, just not having that final piece, that final touch for the Blues. This will be sent out by Seattle on a throw-in for FC Kansas City. Trying to take it quickly is Erica Timrak. And she will give way. Coming down to take it will be Becky Salvin, as the Blues are all forward right now. All on the Seattle side of the pitch. See what Salvin can do with this. Of course, we've seen the evolution of soccer over the last decade or so. The long throw-in has become a very effective weapon. And Becky Salvin sent it up. Shea Groom headed up in the air. And Seattle's going to clear it. Try to launch the counter. Looking ahead to Merritt Mathias, but headed away by Alex Arlette. But the long throw-in from close to the opponent's 18 has become a vital weapon for soccer teams who can find that player. For Sporting KC, that player is Matt Beisler. For international soccer fans, I remember Roy Delap from the English Premier League, who kind of put his stamp on that. Now sent ahead by Merritt Mathias. Kim Little's in front. Trying to turn, but shut down by Avery Bush. Back to Mathias. And Seattle again has built up an attack. Headed away by Alex Arlette. Now here's Seattle again. Boy, if they find the finishing touch, they can wrestle away control of this game. They've had control, but they can certainly take a dominating position in this match. Ellie Reed was on it. Now Fishlock with all the tattoos. Salon. Farside Reed. Inside to Winters. Now trying to go to the full switch for Lauren Barnes. And a left-footed shot blocked away. Nicely done by FC Kansas City's Brittany Taylor. Desiree Scott. So we are in minute 36 now. Still scoreless here in Kansas City. A blazing hot evening in the Midwest. It's Swope Soccer Village, home to many collegiate and high school championships over the last year. They really built up everything around this for youth soccer. The Brookside Soccer Club playing a ton of games here. Now here's Shea Groom with Heather O'Reilly on the right. Passes to O'Reilly. Has an open look. O'Reilly gets Solo. O'Reilly pass Solo. Shot. And into the side netting. Had Hope Solo drawn out. Outside the six. In an open look. And just couldn't put the finishing touch on. But what a run by Shea Groom and Heather O'Reilly. Here's Shea Groom, the Liberty, Missouri kid. There's O'Reilly, Hope Solo comes out, has the keeper rounded over the top, and maybe too much speed on the ball and just couldn't catch up to it in time to get an angle. And lucky for Hope Solo and Seattle Reign FC, but Heather O'Reilly continues to show year after year after year why she is one of the most dependable players. Now Hope Solo may have a problem. Our match official has gone over to the Seattle goalkeeper and is having a word. Initially, Greg Domka has signaled for the sideline for medical attention, but perhaps Hope Solo just wanted a word, and there was a collision there, and she's trying. Maybe she got knocked on the shins a little bit by O'Reilly, or maybe went down a little clumsily. Down the near side, Yanez for Seattle. Nice backheel pass for Keelan Winters. Merritt Mathias. And this attack from Seattle, they just have so many different directions they can go on any possession. And now FC Kansas City will try to launch another counter. Desiree Scott. Heather O'Reilly's just allowed to get wide open on this right side. And Seattle may have to think about that at halftime. Now here's Keelan Winters. Outside, and that's punched away by Everbush. Here's O'Reilly. Here's Shea Groom. And they launch another counter. They've been dangerous on the counter, have FC Kansas City. Just not getting that finishing touch. Heather O'Reilly's had a couple of chances at it now. Just hasn't got the right angle yet. Now O'Reilly calling for the ball, and she'll get it. She's onside. Flag stays down. Still O'Reilly. Here's Taylor making an overlapping run. Now Taylor. Just outside the 18 by 6 yards. Taylor dancing on the ball. Back to Scott. Across the middle to Mandy Laddish. She'll go far side. And that'll be towards FC Kansas City, and this will be a... waiting for an official signal here. This be a corner, could be a corner for FC Kansas City. And it will be. So Seattle Reign FC, which had four corners in the first 5 minutes of the game, have not had one since. This is just the second corner for FC Kansas City, and this will be Heather O'Reilly to take the corner for the Blues. Erica Timrag is also standing out there as well, offering an option for a short corner. This will be a right-footed in-swinger if O'Reilly takes it. It will be the short corner. Timrag tips it off to O'Reilly, sends it up, middle of the 18. Hope Solo tries to punch it away. Desiree Scott mixed up. Bodies on the ground. Finally cleared away by Seattle. Boy, there were some vicious collisions on that corner. There's Shea Groom, slow to get up as Hope Solo tries to give her a hand. Boy, she went down hard. Shea Groom. Hometown kid, Shea Groom, and now here it is again for FC Kansas City. Charging inside the 18, briefly knocked out. And this will be another corner as O'Reilly was on the charge once again. Boy, she flips right side to left side and is equally dangerous from both. And here's a look at that last corner. You can see Shea Groom right there. It's collided into by Hope Solo, who has every right to the ball. So a lot of respect between the two players. Certainly Hope Solo has earned the lion's share of that with her performances over the years. So another right-footed in-swinger for O'Reilly. Will it be another short corner? Or will it be the full corner? Right-footed in-swinger. Lines up. Sends it. Middle. And Hope Solo is there to snatch it out of the air. A sterling save by Hope Solo. We're at minute 41. Scoreless between the two sides. A matchup of titans in the National Women's Soccer League. Seattle, the two-time Shield winners. FC Kansas City, the two-time NWSL champions. Timrak sends it forward to Shea Groom. Has Mandy Laddish in the middle. Sends it across and just misses the left post. And really not that much trouble for Hope Solo. So a goal kick for the Seattle Reign FC keeper. Here's another glance at it here. Shea Groom goes racing in and just maybe can't find the angle here with the left foot. And it's outside. Hope Solo lets that go. And no real danger for the U.S. international star. And that's dangerously left back by Lauren Barnes as she had Katie Bowen in there, and that's kicked away by Hope Solo. And Heather O'Reilly calling for it, wants it immediately, and now there's a second ball on the pitch, so we have to stop play. And Kim Little had to clean up the mess for Seattle Reign FC. Fernanda Mandy Laddish back to Scott. To Averbush. Averbush been a nice pickup for FC Kansas City. Lots of experience in Europe, making her 10th start of the campaign. Had a couple of goals last season playing more of a midfield forward role, coming on as a late sub, but playing defender this season and taking over the position left free by the retirement of Leanne Robinson, now Leanne Brown. I know this FC Kansas City side misses Leanne Brown and all that she did for the team in her 3 years. And now, brief moment of danger for Seattle as Rachel Corsi had to race back and tip it back to Hope Solo. Minute 43. And no indication of added time as of yet. I would expect no more than maybe a minute or two because of the hydration break, but no real major stoppages of play. And I'm looking across the far side to the fourth official, Devin Blazik, and he was looking down at the clock board but has not punched in a number yet. The hydration break was 3 minutes, so perhaps they add on those full three. We'll have to await the indication and the judgment. And as they go to halftime, for FC Kansas City, Vlatko Andonovski will be happy with the way his team has countered Seattle in this game and gotten chances to attack. But he'll have to find a way to unlock the Seattle Reign FC midfield and build up a sustained attack. For Seattle Reign FC, if you're Laura Harvey, simply keep doing what you're doing and just find a finishing touch in the attacking third, because they've enjoyed the possession and great passing here in the first half. I expect a whale of a second half between these two sides. And now perhaps Seattle bleeding the clock a little bit, minute 45. And potential handball there by Yanez, but it hit off the shoulder. And Barnes, Yanez, a little back and forth. Fishlock was calling for it, will not get it. Said Winters will send it back to Corsi. Andy Lattish trying to pick it free for FC Kansas City. Unsuccessful. Maintaining possession was Salon. And Keelan Winters will get it out on that far side to Ellie Reed. And a throw in for the Blues on the far side. Still waiting for an indication of added time here. The end of the first half. Glancing over, and the fourth official still, I believe, waiting for Greg Dobka to give him a final number. Heather O'Reilly tries to clear it out for the Blues, but to no avail as Winters is right there, dancing and spinning on it. Here's Keelan Winters trying to line up a right-footed far post run, and there it is, a header for Seattle, and it's just blazed over the top. And a nice idea by Keelan Winters as she was trying to pick out Salon. And a nice back post run by Salon. Another look here is perfect pinpoint accuracy. The header just not quite spot on. And the signboard is out. It has not been hoisted yet. It looks like 3 minutes, and it will be 3 minutes. So 3 minutes added on, and that is the exact number of minutes this two sides took for the hydration break. So other than that, no real stoppages of play. And now a chance to counter for the Blues. Erica Timrak looking for O'Reilly, and that's a little bit too strong. Hope Solo is out of her net, and O'Reilly couldn't win that race to the ball. Solo got the jump on it. So we have played the 45 minutes. Should have about 2.5 minutes of added time here remaining. Smattering of FC Kansas City fans breaking into the I Believe That We Will Win chant. By the way, the Missouri National Guard here tonight as the FC Kansas City organization honors the military. And before the game, if you did not see it on the online broadcast, Dontarius Young delivered one of the best national anthems I have heard in a long time. It was absolutely outstanding. So if you're in the Midwest and need someone to sing a national anthem, find out how to get in touch with Dontarius Young. Outstanding national anthem. Now here's Heather O'Reilly in the what remains the first half. Still O'Reilly. And she's calling for an obstruction, and she'll get it. This will be a free kick and a dangerous spot for the Blues. And a chance before halftime to perhaps manufacture a little something. We should be in that final third minute of added time. And Heather O'Reilly in no hurry to get the ball back to the free kick area because this could be the last touch of the game as soon as the free kick is taken and whatever the result is of said free kick. And this will be Averbush to take it. And again, she is fantastic. Had a good one earlier in the match. I see Kansas City arranges its troops. And here's Averbush. She'll send it right into the middle of the mixer, and Fishlock was there to tip it away, and it'll be a corner for FC Kansas City as it was off Fishlock. And here's another look. Fishlock, the only body really that was near the ball. Shea Grimm tried to get there. Pardon me, Brittany Taylor tried to get there. And here's O'Reilly, and she'll take a right-footed inswinger. And this should be the final sequence of our first half. Right-footed inswinger sent right in front up in the air, punched away by Hope Solo, and that rolls away, and waiting for a whistle. I thought for sure it would happen after that corner sequence, but the Blues apparently will get another shot to send it in. Shea Groom on it, tips it back. Mandy Laddish tipped towards the post, and Hope Solo will watch it go out of bounds. And this will be another corner for the Blues. And we've got to be well in excess of those 3 minutes, and there's the clock. It's now 3:20 past those initial 3 minutes of added time, and the Blues are going to get another chance here. And here's another look. Mandy Laddish's chance. Look at the tip back by Shea Groom. What a professional play. And Laddish just tipped off another player. And here's Heather O'Reilly's corner set in front. Laddish tips it up and out of bounds. And surely that will get a whistle. Hope Solo waiting for the ball. And there is the whistle from our match official. So the opening half is drawn to a close. Scoreless between FC Kansas City and the visitors from Seattle. Seattle has had most of the possession and some good chances, just unable to finish. And FC Kansas City has had some great counterattacks in that first half. And Heather O'Reilly, a couple of golden opportunities, but just unable to get the right angle. So we'll await the two teams as they head back to the locker rooms, cool off, and regroup and strategize for the second half, and we will set it aside. We'll keep the cameras on for you here, but we will step aside and take a hydration break of our own here. You're watching FC Kansas City and Seattle Reign SC, the National Women's Soccer League.
On your wireless network should always speed up and never stutter. Get the better network. Get Verizon, the 100% LTE network ranked number one in America for overall network performance by Root Metrics. To join in, visit VZW.com. Verizon, better matters.
Research Medical Center is proud to be FC Kansas City's official medical provider. Research Medical Center's team of sports and wellness specialists is ready for any of your healthcare needs, from prevention to injury care. They're here to keep you healthy and active. FC Kansas City fans, please join us in recognizing Heartland soccer referees from all over the KC metro area. These officials can take a lot of heat from coaches, parents, and players throughout the course of each youth soccer season. So please help us show our appreciation to these folks with a big round of applause. Thank you, Heartland referees. Following the referees is our Missouri Team of the Week, the KC Prime Academy U17 Girls, coached by Mark Nardiello and Mike Hayes. These girls won the Missouri President's Cup Championship back in November, and they proceeded to win the Midwest Region 2 Championship last weekend in Indianapolis. Next month, they're competing in the National Championship in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Congratulations, KC Prime Academy U17 Girls. Following them is our Kansas Team of the Week. The Red Hawks are a U14 girls soccer team. They've been together since they were in kindergarten and are about to go into high school next year. These girls have achieved championship success outdoor as well as indoor. They're just as accomplished off the field as they are on it, however, receiving awards and accommodations at school. Now let's set it down to FC Kansas City's Scott Levinson, who has an exciting contest from our friends at Overland Park Fiat.
Thank you, Nate. I'm here with Scott, and he is from Drexel, Missouri. He is going to try and win a $35,000 Fiat from Overland Park Fiat at about 78th and Metcalf. That's 500X Lounge is what he can win. We're changing things up. The first half of the season, we were giving away a Mazda. Now we're going to try and give away a Fiat from Overland Park Fiat. Scott, you going to hit this thing?
Absolutely.
All right. We've backed him up about 25 yards, which is how many feet, Scott?
75.
He doesn't know. We'll get out the calculator later and we'll show you what it is. It's 75 feet. It's a 19-inch cutout. It's a regulation soccer ball. Scott, whenever you're ready, let it fly. Come on, FC Kansas City fans, let's hear it for Scott. He hit the board. Hey, that's okay. Scott, you're not walking away a loser. You still win a free oil change from Overland Park Mazda, Overland Park Fiat. Thanks for being a great contestant. Appreciate it. Back to you, Nate.
Kansas City Transportation Group is the official transportation provider of FC. Leaves your clothes fresh and smelling like thyme. Try dry cleaners. We're changing dry cleaning for good. KC North Spine and Joint Center, the official chiropractors of FC Kansas City, use advanced manual therapy and chiropractic techniques to treat athletic and overuse injuries from all sport-related activities. For more information on how they can help you or the athlete in your life, visit their website at kcnorthsjc.com. Nike is a proud partner of the NWSL and FC Kansas City. Step up, take charge, and spark brilliance at nike.com/soccer. FCKC fans on the field right now are future soldiers of the Missouri Army National Guard, led by Sergeant Nicholas Wheeler. We would like to welcome Major Nelson with Recruiting and Retention Battalion to Swope Park Soccer Village to swear in these National Guard soldiers. Major Nelson is from St. Louis, Missouri, and a graduate from Maryville University. Major Nelson enlisted into the Missouri Army National Guard in 1992 and has two combat tours in Iraq in 2004 to 2005 and 2007 to 2008. He is currently the West Side Recruiting
true faith,
and allegiance to the same,
and that I will obey the orders
of the President of the United States
and the Governor of Missouri
and the orders of the officers
appointed over me
according to regulations
and the Uniform Code,
and the Uniform Code
of Military Justice.
Of Military Justice.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Good job.
Blues fans, let's hear for these brave soldiers and thank them for serving us and our great country.
Save me from having to do it. Thank you for doing that. I know it's hard. You gotta do this for 20 now. Yeah, it's hard to know. It's for you.
great job. Thank you.
Now, FC Kansas City fans, please welcome back to the field Dontarius Young, who became an overnight internet sensation after belting out an incredible rendition of Lee Greenwood's God Bless the USA to customers back on Veterans Day at the Chick-fil-A he works for near Oak Park Mall. His video has now been viewed over 14 million times. Okay, Dontarius, whenever you're ready.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd worked for all my life, and I had to start all over with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, for the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died and gave that right to me. And I proudly stand up next to you and defend her still today. For there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died and gave that right to me. And I proudly stand up next to you and defend her still today. For there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you, Dontarius. FC Kansas City would like to welcome the following group to tonight's game, the Hugh Williams Soccer Camp attendees. Welcome. FC Kansas City would also like to wish happy birthday to the following fans in attendance at tonight's game. Happy 10th birthday to Carly Hummel. And happy birthday to Liza Healer. Tonight's Ball Kids are sponsored by Freestyle Graphics, and tonight's media meal was provided by the title sponsor, FC Kansas City, Domino's. Here are your halftime game statistics. The score currently standing at 0-0 between FC Kansas City and Seattle Reign. Four shots for FC Kansas City, zero on goal. Four shots for Seattle Reign, two on goal. One save credited to FC Kansas City, zero for Seattle. Five corners awarded to FC Kansas City, four for Seattle Reign. Four fouls assessed to FC Kansas City, two for the Seattle Reign.
and one yellow card issued to Seattle Reign in the first half. All right, Blues fans, please welcome back to the pitch our teams for the second half of tonight's game.
And welcome back into Swope Soccer Village in Kansas City, Missouri, as we're about to begin the second half between the home side, FC Kansas City, and the visitors from Seattle. The Seattle Reign FC, a scoreless first half, 0-0 between these two stalwart organizations of the National Women's Soccer League. FC Kansas City, the two-time defending champions. Seattle Reign FC, the two-time shield winners in the National Women's Soccer League, will flip sides. So Seattle, the visitors, moving from left to right. And there's Becky Sauerbrunn from the home side, FC Kansas City. They're in the blue tops with the dark blue shorts, dark blue socks, moving from right to left. And there's Heather O'Reilly, had a couple of chances in the first half. And Seattle Reign FC in a color I can only describe as highlighter yellow, tops, shorts, and socks, now moving from our left to our right. Seattle Reign FC enjoyed a majority of the possession in the first half, just lacked that finish in the final third. FC Kansas City had some great counterattacks in the first half and a couple of good looks by Heather O'Reilly, but just could not finish. And now here's Jessica Fishlock off and running in a backheel pass attempt in front by Yanez for Seattle. And Tip looking for Fishlock back post, and Desiree Scott there to impede her progress, but legally so. And this would be a goal kick for Nicole Barnhart, and Fishlock gives the thumbs up to her teammate. Important match for both sides as Seattle could get right on that edge line for a playoff spot by getting a full 3 points here for FC Kansas City, which got off to that slow start to the season. They could get within 3 points of getting playoff zone, depending on how other results fall this weekend. I was keeping an eye on the Washington Spirit Sky Blue FC score, and Sky Blue FC had a 1-0 lead early in the second half. Merritt Mathias sends it across the front looking for Fishlock, but it's headed away by Averbush. Now on the near side for Seattle, Elliot Reed, and just a little bit too strong pass Mathias, and a throw-in now for FC Kansas City's Alex Arlette. Tip back to Arlette by her teammate, Katie Bowen. Sent ahead. And now cycle it back to Hope Solo. And if you were with us at the beginning of the first half, I mentioned the boiling conditions here in Kansas City. It was 93 degrees at kickoff, and it remains a steady 93 degrees here in Kansas City. So should those conditions hold, you can expect a hydration break somewhere in the neighborhood of minute 75, give or take, depending on when there is a stoppage in play. So we did see that in minute 30 of the first half, or rather more accurately, close to minute 26, but that was the target area, so I expect to see that here in the second half. Erica Timrak off the shoulder, Shea Groom, and bodies ping-ponging around on the near side. This has been a very physical match. It really got physical past the 10-minute mark, and we saw a big showdown between Merritt Mathias of Seattle Reign FC and Shea Groom of FC Kansas City on a set piece, and the referee, our match official, Greg Dopka, was not happy with either and called them both for a stern lecture. That's a case of two players you would expect to be hard-headed and not give an inch actually be hard-headed and not give an inch. Now here's FC Kansas City on the break. Katie Bowen leading the charge forward, and watch that roll out, and this will be a Seattle goal kick for Hope Solo. And a nice run there by the number 13, Brittany Taylor, for FC Kansas City. Many of these players on the field tonight will be heading out for training with the U.S. national team in the days ahead. And a tune-up match against South Africa coming up July the 9th. That'll be in Chicago. First ever meeting between the two sides. And then the final tune-up before the Rio Olympics will be July 22nd here in Kansas City over at Children's Mercy Park in Kansas City, Kansas, and a giveaway by O'Reilly, a rare giveaway. Fishlock has it for Seattle, and they'll bounce it around the far side. Yanez. Fishlock cycles back again. And here in front of the press box, we see newly sworn-in members of the Missouri National Guard. That happened at halftime, a group of young men and women who have pledged their allegiance to protect and defend the United States of America, and also here within the state of Missouri. And a young man, Dontarius Young, and there's the young soldiers who've been sworn into the Missouri National Guard. And their leaders and commanders wearing the full outfit, the long sleeves and the undershirt and the long pants and the combat boots. And we had a 93-degree day. I can only imagine what our young men and women experience in the deserts of the Middle East. In terms of the heat, now here's an attack. Erica Timrak in for FC Kansas City, and it's nicely chopped away by Ellie Reed of Seattle Reign FC, and this will be the sixth corner of the game coming up for the Blues after five in the first half. Here's another look with Timrak charging in, and Ellie Reed, a nice job just to bend the spokes a little bit. Seattle Reign FC had four corners in the first half, all within the first 5 or 6 minutes. Heather O'Reilly lines up with a right-footed in-swinger, but we did see one short corner in the first half with Timrak standing by, and this will go far post and body down inside the 18 as Becky Salbrun, but no call is made. Salbrun now tips it away, Averbush in front, and the whistle is blown. There's a foul inside the 18, so this will be a goal kick for Seattle. There's Erica Timrak, former Rookie of the Year for FC Kansas City. Part of both championship squads, University of Florida product from Bradenton. Now, nice job by Keelan Winters to step in front, and Merritt Mathias. And now, Yanez for Seattle. There's Kim Little all the way back from a forward position, and she'll make a run off the pass. Your near side is Ellie Reed, who had the great defensive stop on the last charge for the Blues, assessing her options. And a little bit too strong as she was looking for Merritt Mathias, and this will be a goal kick for Nicole Barnhart. And actually, this will be a free kick as it's a foul on Seattle. Becky Salbrun will send it back to Barnhart. We have so many solid defensive players between the two sides for FC Kansas City. Becky Salbrun, best central midfielder in the world, backed up by Nicole Barnhart. And over on the Seattle side with Lauren Barnes, Rachel Corsi, Ellie Reed, Kendall Fletcher. It's just a solid back line in front of Hope Solo. So a scoreless standing at this point is not all that much a surprise right now. See if either side can break through and try to steal the 3 points. Heather O'Reilly out for the corner for the Blues. This will be a right-footed outswinger, should she choose that route. And there it is, sending it to the far post. Hope Solo punches it away, but it's still in front. Dangerous before it's initially cleared out, but Desiree Scott able to hold it in after Salon did not clear it all the way. Now making a run, Lauren Barnes. This will be a throw-in on the far side for FC Kansas City. And there's a good look at Lauren Barnes, the UCLA product, making her 10th start. Played in Melbourne for the Victory with Jessica Fishlock. 20 starts last season, played 1,800 minutes, an indispensable part of that Seattle defense. Now Desiree Scott has it chopped away. And that's by Kim Little, who's all the way back from her forward position. So a defensive midfielder and a forward going head-to-head inside the 18. And that's the way championship clubs and shield-winning clubs play. All in, every play. There O'Reilly with another corner for the Blues. She sends the right-footed in-swinger just to the near side, and that hits the netting. And that'll be a goal kick for Hope Solo. And so you can see the shadows descending behind Hope Solo, but for Nicole Barnhart on the opposite end, the sun is right in her face. So Hope Solo has the sun behind her with shadows creeping in on the near side of the field. That temperature has still not gone down from the initial 93 degrees. And what a battle between Fishlock and Scott. Now Yanez has it. Now Scott. Mandy Laddish. Look at Heather O'Reilly making a run on the right side. And it's O'Reilly. Can she win the race to get there? It's O'Reilly with Shea Groom making a run centrally. Tipped up. And it's way out. But what a run by Heather O'Reilly. Just speed to burn. You look at Heather O'Reilly at age 31, the North Carolina product who's played so many games for club and country. Called into the U.S. national team camp ahead of that July 9th game against South Africa. And Jill Ellis would be well served by making use of her speed and talent, which she has several occasions before. And that's headed away by Yanez. And now Seattle trying to launch a counter. This will be sent to the near side, Keelan Winters, looking for Fishlock. And a dummy pass, and here's Kim Little. Kim Little trying to get a shooting angle. Still Kim Little, top of the 18. Cycling back, Desiree Scott pokes it away, and well done by the Canadian international, and Seattle still able to get a shot off. And Nicole Barnhart not too troubled with that effort. But Desiree Scott, well done to get back. And Desiree Scott will be on the Canadian Olympic squad in Rio here in a few weeks. The summer of soccer simply will not end. Mandy Lattish, a nice job to maintain possession for the Blues. Erica Timrak has Shea Groom, and there is Shea Groom inside the 18. Shea Groom looking to send it across, and does, and it's kicked away by Seattle, and another great defensive stop, and it's Kim Little again back from her forward position. Kim Little, outstanding box-to-box forward. Take another glance at it here as Shea Groom, and trying to catch back is Ellie Reed. And as Shea Groom sends it right across the goal, there is Kim Little. Outstanding by Kim Little. Would expect nothing less from the Seattle veteran. Here's Jessica Fishlock looking up, and she has Merritt Mathias. It's a one-on-three break, and Avery Bush is there to disrupt it, but it's still Merritt Mathias and a left-footed shot, and no problem for Nicole Barnhart as she gets an ice ovation from the home crowd. Minute 57, still scoreless here in Kansas City. Two sides creating chances, but neither able to put the finishing touches on yet. And a throw-in for Seattle forthcoming on the far side. Tip back for Kendall Fletcher, the 31-year-old out of North Carolina, making her 10th start of the season. Hope Solo will send it up the near side. Keelan Winters, Ellie Reed, and stepping in is Mandy Lattish. And boy, she has been quite a find. The kid from Lee Summit, Missouri, Notre Dame product, 2014 draft pick for FC Kansas City. And now here's Seattle FC in front, looking wide open, a shot across, and boy, I really thought Salon would take it. Instead, she tried to pass, maybe a bit too generous there. And now here's Heather O'Reilly. And again, just all eight cylinders, making a 12-cylinder Rolls-Royce. She might be out of gas. Erica Timrak inside the 18, and now a whistle because there's a Seattle player down, and a whistle is blown while the attack is in progress in the 18. And it looks like Jessica Fishlock is the player down for Seattle. But why was the whistle blown with a full attack in progress? And FC Kansas City clearly did not see Fishlock down behind the play. They continued forward, and they had a scoring opportunity. And now the players will make their way towards their respective sidelines to try to get some liquids in. Now, I believe a yellow card has been issued to Desiree Scott. We will double check that, but clearly Jessica Fishlock is in some pain, and there's Desiree Scott. She's having a discussion with her teammate, Brittany Taylor. Now Fishlock will make her way toward the sideline. It's always good to see a player up and moving. See if she is able to continue play. monitor that situation. So players from both sides have gotten some liquid refreshment during this brief stop and play. We'll see if that affects a hydration, possible hydration break later in the match. Fishlock is talking with her coach, Laura Harvey, on the far side. See if she can continue on. And I would bet if I had $100 in my pocket, I'd put all 100 on Fishlock coming back into this match. She's getting some cool liquid, and yeah, she said she's good to go. So she'll have to wait to be waved on by Greg Dobka. And she waits. Now she's been sent on by the fourth official. So Seattle Reign FC down to 10 players for essentially about 5 seconds. So Fishlock back out, and she's walking gingerly right now. See how that affects her play. She's perhaps the most important player for Seattle Reign FC and has been for years. And there she is. She's trying to get back up to speed, and you can see she's not 100%. And a nice job by Alex Arlette. Get it out for the Blues. Shea Groom back from her forward spot. Over Mandy Lattish. Desiree Scott is there in a good battle with Yanez. Tipped in by Erica Timrak, but it's tipped in the feet of Kim Little, and she tries to send it across to Fishlock. Fishlock is just circling, waiting for an opportunity. Kim Little sends it in front. Again, she was trying to find Salon or Yanez. And Desiree Scott will send it to Mandy Lattish, patrolling the midfield. Out to Heather O'Reilly. We'll see who can make a run for FC Kansas City. Katie Bowen is down. And there is Heather O'Reilly. She rounds her defender. Still O'Reilly. Sends it in front, and nobody home. FC Kansas City players had either broken off their runs or didn't feel they could get there in time. Katie Bowen was on the far side, but in no position to get into a spot to shoot. Shea Groom was there as well. You wonder how many of those opportunities FC Kansas City can fail to take advantage of before it comes back to bite them. Here's Seattle Reign FC as we're in minute 62. Far side, Fishlock making a run. Merritt Mathias, boy, they continue to just, like sharks, circle in front for Seattle. And here's O'Reilly again. How much gas does she have in the tank this time? Shea Groom making a run centrally. Shea Groom wanting it. The pass in front. Shea Groom hopes Solo is out, and Groom has to leap over the U.S. international goalkeeper. Well done by Hope Solo again. Shea Groom has made some fantastic runs tonight, but to no avail in terms of putting a dent in the scoreboard. Mentioned in the first half, Hope Solo with an opportunity to make soccer history. And here's Merritt Mathias. Flag stays now. The flag is up. Initially, it looked like she might be a step on, but she is off. But Hope Solo with a chance to make international history in the next couple of weeks. She's sitting on 99 career shutouts for the United States women's national team. And the game against South Africa will, on July 9th, will give her first chance at number 100. And that would be an international as well as U.S. record. Yeah, Merritt Mathias was a good step and a half to 2 steps offside. Substitution for Seattle is Salon is off. Salon has been withdrawn in minute 64. And it's Manon Mellis in for Seattle. So Manon Mellis, 29-year-old from Rotterdam. And down hard again is Jessica Fishlock, and this will be a free kick, and Averbush the culprit this time around. But Manon Mellis in. So again, the veteran from Rotterdam. Played 5 games for Seattle Reign FC last year, 304 minutes, signed the beginning of this season, pardon me, your 6th appearance of the campaign. Played so many years in Sweden, over 100 international caps, but she is retired from the Dutch national team. But a good veteran presence to be able to call on in the second half. Here's Fishlock, and she bumps Becky Salvren, 2 international stars crashing into each other. And that's sent in front, but unable to link up for that final touch with Rachel Corsi.
Substitution on the field for Seattle Reign, now entering the game. Number 16, Carson Pickett, replacing number 3, Lauren Barnes.
So now Lauren Barnes has been withdrawn for Seattle, and Carson Pickett is in minute 66. So 2 substitutions in the last couple of minutes for Laura Harvey's side. And Lauren Barnes out, Carson Pickett in. Manon Mellis entered the game about a minute and a half before that. So 2 substitutions here early in the second half for Seattle, and there may be a third coming as Seattle's bench continues to stir. FC Kansas City has yet to make a substitution. They have all 3 available. Throw in on the near side for Seattle Reign FC. Merritt Mathias doing battle with Alex Arlette. And boys, Alex Arlette has really earned her keep. The beginning of her professional career for FC Kansas City. Avery Bush will send it away for the Blues. Tracking back, Rachel Corsi. All the way back to Hope Solo. And that's back to Corsi and back to Solo. A little ping pong back and forth. Instead, they'll try to unlock the left flank. Keelan Winters. Inez now up top to Mellis, who's just introduced. See Kansas City, Brittany Taylor. Looking for Shea Groom if she can get a step in front. And she'll be turned by Rachel Corsi, who will cycle it back to Hope Solo. But not for a lack of opportunities for these two sides, just that little finish. Have not seen yet. Still scoreless as we approach the 70th minute of play here in Kansas City, Missouri, Swope Soccer Village. And I mentioned the heat earlier, 93 degrees. It's natural grass surface, and the header from Arlette sends her to the grass. And now this could be on for FC Kansas City. Shea Groom, O'Reilly making a run. Here's O'Reilly. Right side, shot with the right foot, and that's deflected out of play. Nice job by Seattle. Getting back, and a high five for Carson Pickett, who was just introduced a couple of minutes ago. And here's O'Reilly again. You watch that charge after the feet ahead, and here's Carson Pickett. Just gets in front to deflect it for another Blues corner. It'll be a short corner. Erica Timrak dancing on the ball back to O'Reilly, assessing her options. Left-footed chip up front. Bodies in the air. Becky Salvern was there, and a whistle for a foul call. And this will be a goal kick for Hope Solo and Seattle. See the flag on the far side. Seattle has been favoring FC Kansas City's right flank in this second half, and now they'll try to go down the opposite side. Mellis. And now Desiree Scott for the Blues, up to Erica Timrak. And she can make deadly runs on occasion. She got Shea Groom as an option, and she'll take Shea Groom as the option. Heather O'Reilly charging in as well. Here's Shea Groom looking for a shooting angle, perhaps a passing angle. Still Shea Groom in front, lays it off. Mandy Laddish, Desiree Scott. So the threat is blunted by the Seattle defense, which has been rock solid. They've let a couple of angled shots make their way towards the net, but nothing direct. And now here's O'Reilly. Chips it across, looking for Shea Groom. And again, just one final touch for either side could steal the 3 points. Merritt Mathias, guarded by Arlette. Little battling with Arlette. Merritt Mathias making the overlapping run, and Mathias will get it. Here's Mathias trying to get towards that 18, sends it in front. Dangerous as Yanez was making her way in from the opposite corner, and Yanez will bring it back, and Seattle will have another chance here. Shot sent in, and we left the post. I'll actually assume that was a pass, but we're now into minute 70. Goal kick for Nicole Barnhart. Haverbusch. And it makes its way back to Barnhart. We've seen this a couple of times from the Blues tonight. Just trying to find some semblance of a crease in that Seattle pressure. Desiree Scott, now Haverbusch. Mandy Laddish tried to send it up front, looking initially for Katie Bowen. Now with Kansas City attackers rolling in, including Bowen, Hope Solo will send that out of bounds and a throw in for FC Kansas City on the far side. And several FC Kansas City players are now up and warming on that far sideline. So we could see Vlatko Andonovski again to begin to initiate a substitution pattern here. Again, Seattle has used two subs so far. Carson Pickett has come into the game here in the second half, and so has Mellis. Those were both within the first 12 to 13 minutes of our second half. A goal kick for Hope Solo coming up. And here is a hydration break. We kind of explained that at the beginning of the show. The match official, Greg Dobka, as well as officials from the National Women's Soccer League, were on the field before the game taking temperature readings. And they had all come to the conclusion that it was hot enough to sanction hydration break. So this will last 3 minutes, as it did in the first half. Those 3 minutes will be added on at the back end of regulation, which we did see at the end of the first half. And again, not only hydration, but also a little strategy session for each of the coaches, Vlatko Andonovski and Laura Harvey. Well, you give them a pregame prep, you give them the halftime adjustments, you throw in one hydration break per half, and these coaches can do a lot of things. Two of the top tier coaches in the National Women's Soccer League. Speaking of hydration breaks, big shout out to Brad Zimmerman and his production staff who put all the cameras and monitors in place to bring you this online broadcast. He and his crew have been here all day today, running cable, putting up gear, and under brutally hot conditions. And Brad, I hope you guys have been able to get some hydration breaks yourselves today, because it has been a tough go. Those guys are true professionals, and they allow us to bring this to you, not only in Kansas City and Seattle, but anywhere around the world. Just log in and take in the game. There's Hope Solo, and top keeper for the U.S. national team for so many years, and can't see that ending anytime soon. 34 years old, but she's getting a high fire from Kendall Fletcher, and those two have done a great job tonight against the Kansas City attack. Keelan Winters, the captain for Seattle. Nice thing for Hope Solo, as you can see the sun. It's at her back here for the second half. FC Kansas City, there's number 21, Katie Bowen, discussing things with Mandy Laddish and some adjustments they might want to make for the final 16-plus minutes here of our match. Shea Groom has had a couple of opportunities. Texas A&M grad, Liberty, Missouri product. Draft pick of FC Kansas City. It's a big night for sports here in the Midwest. FC Kansas City playing here at Swope Soccer Village. Sporting Kansas City from Major League Soccer, playing up in Canada. Desiree Scott's neck of the woods, but they're in Montreal, which is not exactly from her neck of the woods, but that's her country. And the Kansas City Royals are playing just down the road against the Houston Astros, although things are not going well for the defending world champs. Now here's Heather O'Reilly. Who else making that run down the far side? Charges into the 18. Look at her. Viciousness in front. Hope Solo is on it. Heather O'Reilly can just slice you apart, but Hope Solo can thwart any attack. She had plenty of reinforcements back. Averbush gets ahead on it. As O'Reilly tips it for Laddish. Desiree Scott with Merritt Mathias coming right up from behind. Alex Arlette being told to get it back to Sauerbrunn, and she does, and all the way back to Barnhart. Again, trying to unlock that puzzle that is Seattle Reign FC in that midfield. Counter's been good. Trying to put together a sustained attack has been challenging at times. Minute 76, still scoreless. Shea Groom with Erica Timrak on the left. Heather O'Reilly on the right, still Shea Groom, and she's double-teamed and taken down, but no chance of a penalty. Instead, she's earned a corner for the Blues. Nice double-team effort by Seattle Reign FC. Another look at it here. And well done by both Kendall Fletcher and Carson Pickett, the second half sub, to blunt the opportunity for Shea Groom. Heather O'Reilly to take the corner with Timrak as a possibility should she want to go short. O'Reilly, the right-footed outswinger, sends it to the near post, and it's headed away nicely by Yanez. Desiree Scott holds it in as she beats Kim Little in the battle center. In front, bodies up in the air. Hope Solo's down. Shea Groom is down. What a collision right in front. And a nice sporting effort by Seattle as they help Shea Groom up off the turf. But what a collision by those two players, Shea Groom and Hope Solo. And another glance at it here. Boy, they both went down like a ton of bricks. Hope Solo can't afford to be on the ground. She hopped up in a hurry to make sure there wasn't another shot coming. Here's Erica Timrak, one-on-one with Kim Little. Still Timrak, and still against Kim Little. To the near side, Alex Arlette. And did Merritt Mathias hold it in? No, this will be a throw-in for FC Kansas City. Alex Arlette, a yeoman's effort tonight along that left flank for FC Kansas City. Continues to earn starts and minutes as a rookie in this league. Out of LSU, she was on the All-SEC tournament team last year, and she's number 3 in LSU history in appearances with 89. 87 of those were starts, so she's used to playing a lot of minutes and a lot of games from her college time at Louisiana State. Heather O'Reilly all the way back. Becky Sauerbrunn. She'll be headed to the Olympics this summer in Rio. Arlette. Erica Timrak. Still Timrak. She can just eat up acres of space staying on the ball. And here's O'Reilly on that far side. Making another run inside the 18. She'll lay it back and get it back. Still O'Reilly looking for an angle to pass. Well done by that Seattle defense. Pickett. Now again charging in FC Kansas City. Crossing pass in front, and Arlette can't get ahead to it. Arlette will hold it in for the Blues towards that near corner, and this will be a throw-in for FC Kansas City as it's off Merritt Mathias. Alex Arlette, what an effort tonight. And FC Kansas City is preparing to make a sub here. And coming into the game for FC Kansas City.
Substitution for FC Kansas City.
will be number 88, Alexa Newfield. So Katie Bowen will be withdrawn. So Bowen is out. Katie Newfield now in. Number 88 for FC Kansas City. The first substitution for Vlatko Andonovsky. So he has two more he can use. Lauren Harvey for Seattle has used two of her three allotted substitutions. Mara Mathias tries to get it up, and it's an offside flag. As a little too anxious were Fishlock and Mellis. And Fishlock has had a great game tonight as well. Taking some hard knocks from the FCKC players. But that's standing operating procedure for any team playing against Seattle in the National Women's Soccer League. Still scoreless, minute 81. And FC Kansas City looks like they're going to send Francis Silva in with their next substitution, but not before Heather O'Reilly tries to get another chance. So Francis Silva will head on for whatever's left of this match. Other than the three-minute hydration break, not much to talk about in terms of time, although Fishlock was down for a good 3 minutes. So we could see somewhere between 4 and 6 minutes added on at the end of regulation. So Francis Silva still waiting to be waved on for FC Kansas City. Here's O'Reilly. Send it back to Newfield. Now Mandy Laddish. Still Laddish out wide. It's O'Reilly. And another corner for FC Kansas City. Now Francis Silva will be introduced. And it looks like Erica Timrak will be the player withdrawn for FC Kansas City. We'll await confirmation on that. And they're not waving Francis Silva on. They're gonna wait for the corner. They are gonna make the substitution. So Erica Timrak out in minute 82. Francis Silva is now in. So for Francis Silva, this is her ninth appearance of the season. And that'll draw the curtains on Erica Timrak's 10th appearance and 8th start. Francis Silva, a local kid from Blue Valley North High School, played collegiately at West Virginia. He's played for the U23s in that Six Nations Tour in 2014. Made 15 appearances for the Blues last season. Now here's Becky Sovereign trying to keep up the FC Kansas City attack. Alex Arlette will send it back in front. No trouble for Hope Solo. So each side has now used two of their three substitutions as we're in minute 83. You can see anywhere from 4 to 6 minutes of added time at the end of regulation. Jessica Fishlock battling with Silva, just introduced by the Blues. Merritt Mathias, the former Blues player, now in possession. And she's chopped down by Silva, and this will be a free kick for Seattle Reign FC. Here's another look at this battle between Silva and Fishlock. Or Silva and Mathias, pardon me. And Silva says, I got the ball! But she took out Mathias in the process. Our match official, Greg Dopka, says, nope, that's a free kick. Kim Little is there to stand over it, as is Carson Pickett, one of the second half subs for Laura Harvey. And Pickett will give way. Kim Little will send it into the mixer. And up into the air went Keelan Winters. Seattle still maintains possession. Send it in, and dangerous in front as Pickett was there, but now Francis Silva will try to clear it. It does initially, and it will roll out for a Seattle throw-in on the near side. Calling for it is Ellie Reed. Kim Little. Kim Little has been from not 18 to 18, but 6 to 6. Man alive, is her work rate unreal. There's Reed. Yanez. Reed, Yanez, a little back and forth. Alex Arlette steps in. Francis Silva, a little fancy footwork. But Kim Little trying to get the better of it. And this will be a free kick for the Blues. And Kim Little says, hey, I thought I was grabbed. But Francis Silva did well to win that free kick for FC Kansas City, minute 85. The local kid from Blue Valley North did well there. Sovereign will restart the attack for the Blues. Are there 3 points to be found for either side, or will the spoils be shared between Seattle and Kansas City? Great National Women's Soccer League action here in the Midwest. Desiree Scott, shoved from behind by Ellie Reed, but maintains possession, or by Inez, pardon me. Now here's Ava Bush, cycling to the other side. Laddish was under pressure from Fishlock. And now it's going to go all the way back to Barnhart, who has to clear it out. Now just into the game. Newfield seeing she can put a stamp on it. It's Desiree Scott. Well, it's fast and furious right now as try to smash and grab three here, as the Blues are. They are on. Inside to Alex Arlette. The defender pushing all the way forward. Sends it to the far side, looking for O'Reilly, but comes up short. And now launching the counter, trying to Seattle, but it's given away. Laddish has it. Still Laddish. O'Reilly is calling for it. O'Reilly will get it. Still O'Reilly lays it off, cross in front, and it's just misses Francis Silva, who was subbed in a few minutes ago, and now Seattle will use the third and final substitution to their availability. We'll take a look at the cross again here. This was absolutely fantastic. It was just tipped away, perhaps, by a Seattle defender.
Substitution on the field for the Seattle Reign, now entering the game with 25, Kristen Dahlstrom, replacing number 9, Merritt Mathias.
Kristen Dahlstrom will come in place of Merritt Mathias. Kristen Dahlstrom. Mathias did an outstanding job tonight for Dahlstrom. This is her 7th appearance of the season. She's only made 2 starts, but the Kirksville, Missouri native who played collegiately at Washington State has been a big piece of Seattle for the last few years. So Dahlstrom in. All substitutions now burned for Seattle. FC Kansas City still has one at their disposal if they want to use it. Minute 87, still scoreless. 3 points still available, if not sharing one each. A little bit too far ahead for Little. Desiree Scott with Dahlstrom right behind. Look at Desiree Scott spinning, and Dahlstrom, what pressure. Desiree Scott gets it and holds it on with 2 feet as Dahlstrom goes past her. What an effort by Desiree Scott. Now Mandy Laddish will send it to Avery Bush. Do they have enough to mount another attack? How much in the tank does Heather O'Reilly have? She's been burning NASCAR premium fuel all night long. Is there enough left? Alex Arlette is there with Nicole Barnhart out of the 18. Whew! Alex Arlette may have saved the day. Minute 88. And now it's off. Shea Groom is there. Flag stays down. Still Shea Groom. Pump solo is out. Shea Groom. Keeper is out. And it's not to be for Shea Groom and FC Kansas City, but what an effort and what a run and what a buildup. What a counter. Another look here as she gives a thumbs up to her teammate. Charges him past Corsi. Hope Solo comes up to match, and perhaps that was enough pressure. Unable to turn and keep it from flying out. Goal kick for Hope Solo. All the runs Shea Groom and Heather O'Reilly have had tonight. Just got to remember, the person standing there waiting is Hope Solo, and she's the best in the world. Even if it's just a deflection, even if it changes your thought pattern, convinces you to take an angle that's not comfortable, she's going to find a way. Winters tries to send it down that far side. Back to Avery Bush. Minute 89. This will be the Blues throw-in. And we'll await for an indication of added time, I would think, between 3 and 6 minutes. The 3-minute hydration break plus the injury to Fishlock. And now a whistle. Referee is reaching for a card, and we're going to see a red! Straight red issued to Seattle. And for Carson Pickett, the second half sub, she is gone. FC Kansas City will play with an advantage for for the final minutes, whatever's added on here, regulation, whatever's added on. So Carson Pickett, the second half sub, a red card, straight red. And it's minute 90, Carson Pickett, sent away, straight red. And Avery Bush is lining up for a free kick, so a man advantage. With whatever time we have left, there's been no indication from our fourth official yet. Keeps looking at his signboard. We're not seeing anything. Boy, Laura Harvey is not happy. She's calling over the fourth official to have a discussion. Now they're changing. Well, they had moved the free kick up, and now they've moved it back. Still no indication of our added time. Avery Bush standing over it. One man advantage for FC Kansas City. It's a short free kick. Desiree Scott back to Avery Bush. She'll send it inside the 18. Down inside was Shea Groom. No call. Now Becky Sauerman will try to chase it down. And this will be a goal kick for Hope Solo. And the indication is 5 minutes of added time. So 5 minutes have been added on. That's what we have left. That's what FC Kansas City has to try to use their player advantage. Carson Pickett sent off, straight red in the 90th minute. Hope Solo sends it out. Francis Silva is there, but Keelan Winters wins that battle. But not for long as Alex Arlette is there, charging with Kim Little in tow. Still Alex Arlette. Still Arlette trying to get around Reed, and Reed clears it out. That'll be a corner for the Blues. And if you want to take advantage, last week Becky Salbrun scored the NWSL goal of the week off a corner kick, her header. Was the first corner kick converted this season for the Blues. So dare to dream if you're a Blues fan, as Alexa Newfield, second half sub, will line up to take this. Francis Silva is there in case the short corner is an option. Alexa Newfield, right-footed in swinger. And she goes way past the far post, but still inside the 18, headed by Salbrun. And that'll be out in a goal kick for Hope Solo. 5 minutes of added time again. 5 minutes of added time. We are one and a half through that. There's Alexa Newfield, who took that corner. Man advantage for FC Kansas City. Seattle Reign FC's Carson Pickett, straight red in the 90th minute. She was a second half sub. And that is won by Becky Salbrun. Can Shea Groom get there? Headed down, dangerous in front. And this will be back to Hope Solo. Boy, Hope Solo's got a... Her and her teammates got to think, maybe, just hold on for a point right now. A man down with at least 3 more minutes to play. Well, if they could get out of here with a point against a team they have not had much luck against over the last 3.5 seasons, that would be big. FC Kansas City, any point helps right now, but 3 would be huge. Alex Arlette tries to shove off her attacker, Mellis. A battle in the corner, and this will be a corner for Seattle. Bodies going forward now. Seattle will have a golden opportunity here. 5 minutes of added time. We are 2.5 through that. Corner to be taken by Kim Little. Nearly every body is forward for Seattle. Save a couple. They can't afford to give up 3 points on the counter. Nicole Barnhart skies in the air to pull it down. Now, can FC Kansas City pull a smash and grab here and come away with 3? On their home field, the 2-time defending champions against the 2-time Shield winners. Here comes the press for the Blues. There's Heather O'Reilly trying to win the foot race. And this will be a throw-in for Seattle. Attendance tonight, 3,041. 3,041. Heather O'Reilly trying to get her team maybe a sliver of an opportunity to get the full 3 points here. Certainly don't want to give up a goal. But getting one would be huge. And everybody is giving everything they have left. These teams are spent. In the blistering heat, this game has been played at a high pace, 12 cylinders. gear number 6, maybe a 7th if you got it. Everybody reaching down for anything that's left in the tank. Final minute of those 5 added minutes. Shea Groom leaving it all on the field. And that final minute of added time, again, Seattle FC playing down a player, Carson Pickett, straight red in the 90th. So FC Kansas City's had a player advantage for the entire 5 minutes of added time. Foul on the Blues. Free kick for Seattle Reign FC. Perhaps a final opportunity here. Lining up is Kendall Fletcher. Fletcher sends it in front towards Kim Little, but headed away by the much taller Averbush. Kim Little will not get that before it rolls out of bounds. FC Kansas City, throw in, trying to get it to O'Reilly. Whistle coming soon. We're in that past the 5th minute of added time. Becky Sauerbrunn, it's a foul on her, and Seattle's going to have a free kick. And it could be a yellow card on Sauerbrunn, and it will. Yellow on the captain, Becky Sauerbrunn, as Fishlock went down again. And we'll take another peek at it here. Fishlock was charging in, and Sauerbrunn stepped in. And boy, it's hard to tell from that angle. It didn't look like she got much of the ball, though. And Fishlock has been hammered repeatedly tonight. And that's when you're the most dangerous player on the other team, that's what happens. So free kick and a chance for Seattle to rob 3 points on the road. And I use that term, rob, just to... In terms of the time of the game, it's certainly, if they were to get the 3, it's earned, either side. Scoreless draw would be a fair result. And there is the final whistle. And this game will end scoreless. So 1 point each for FC Kansas City and Seattle Reign FC. Well done by both sides. A hard-fought game, a physical game, chances for both sides. But it ends 1-1. So for FC Kansas City, they'll go to 2-4-4 and move up to 10 points. And for Seattle Reign FC, they'll go to 3-3-4 and up to 13 points. And that's a big, big point for both sides. Hope Solo, well done for Seattle Reign FC. Nicole Barnhart, well done for FC Kansas City. Players and coaches should be proud of both sides. Hard-fought, well-fought game. And I'm sure each side is a little disappointed with the final result, but fair is what it was. So that is the final, 0-0 here in Kansas City between FC Kansas City and Seattle Reign FC. Wanted to say thanks to Brad Zimmerman and his entire production team who were here in the boiling heat all day, setting up cable and running equipment everywhere and just do a fantastic job. And also thanks to the FC Kansas City staff for all the prep work they do as well. So that's the final here, 0-0. We'll see you next time from Kansas City. We hope you enjoyed this presentation of the National Women's Soccer League.